So hello, my name is Redon. Before starting, I wanted to ask if I was thinking before making the presentation of how many countries are there or cities that do not have any Nextcloud community. And I think there are a lot of them, which means the potential of getting expanded is huge and getting more people involved in the community. So I'm part of the Albanian Mozilla community, which Silva talked yesterday, and it's active less than a year. And we've worked on some project, mainly on localization, which seems to be the most interesting, let's say the most easy part to start getting involved in a free open source community. And we also started the Telegram group, but we are not very proud of it, as we saw yesterday and the last 2 days. Anyway, so I'm from a city. It's called Elbasan. It's in the middle of it's in the middle of Albania. Some of the people here have been there for our yearly conference. It has different good things to eat. This is called simita me bugache, which is from Turkey. It's very nice, not healthy at all. This is another drink. It's called boz. It's with flavor. It's also Turkish oriented. It's not healthy at all. It has a lot of sugar. And balakume. Balakume is a very traditional. If you come to our yearly conference, you're going to have this. It's a traditional thing we give to every participant in the conference as well. So if you want to have it, I'm going to share the slides. It's also not healthy at all. It has a lot of sugar and butter, a lot of butter. And this is the recipe for to do it. If you go on Wikipedia, we edited the page and it's quite good now. One of the things, I was born in 83, one of the things we were doing there is that we were asking if we didn't have one of the ingredients, for example sugar, we're going to the neighbors and we're getting it, which was very, very nice. After the 1990s, 91, when the regime changed, we became really not having a collective spirit, but really individuals. So this thing stopped. It was very nice at the moment. So after this, I moved to Athens, and I was feeling really weird about the things that I liked, because no one else was into that, until I went to the hackerspace, the local hackerspace in Athens, which was opened many years ago. And I felt that there are other people like me that have the same interests. I'm not a weirdo. There are people that have, you know, like what I do as well, and I like what they do, and we could, you know, share stuff with each other. In 2010, I went back to Albania. There was nothing there in terms of a community, and I made a trip before that in Kosovo, in Pristina, and I saw that there was a very interesting conference, Software Freedom Kosovo. And Kosovo, in case you don't know, it had war years before that. So it struck me. I said, like, this is pretty weird. How can a country that had war be interested in something that, in my perception back then, was a first world problem, issue, like free software and open source software? So I was searching online, and this is from a mailing list. There were some people from 2010 working on creating a free software open source community. Nothing was done. And I found, like, me and some other friends, we thought, hey, this is very important to have a free and to have a physical space in order to talk about these things, and people not to meet only online, just like we are doing here in a conference. The atmosphere needs to be relaxed. You don't get, this is very important, you will not get judged if you don't know certain skills, which is a very big issue in Albania. We were grown up believing that you don't have to ask questions, because that might be a stupid question. I'm pretty sure this is in other countries as well, but this is very bad if you want to create a community. Like, if people don't interact, that's very not productive. And of course, we're focused on free open source software, online privacy, and open knowledge. These were the things we were focused on. But why I'm sharing all these details, because Silva yesterday was in went into details about our community. It's very important to understand that every community is very different. What works in a country like Albania or a city like Tirana doesn't work in another city. Where I was talking with Stathis these days, and the Greek community is something totally different, needs a totally different approach. So if you want to jumpstart a community in one city or country, you have to keep this in mind. A very cheap space is very important. If you call it a hackerspace, that's good. But a physical space to meet people is very, very important. Cafeterias work, But if you own it, you are part of the thing. And of course, support of established projects from, let's say, Mozilla or Nextcloud or Fedora or SUSE is very, very important. Support doesn't mean actually only, let's say travel support, but also if you give swag or other elements, these are very, give a positive vibe to the community. So ambassador programs for countries like Albania, I think for other countries, I was in Pakistan and these programs work there as well. I'm pretty sure they work in India because people get this, they say they're proud to be something that are rewarded, right? So being a Fedora ambassador, for example, works, or also being a Mozilla Reps program works, and it's a very nice start for young people to get into these communities. And of course, travel support for young people, with caution always, because it involves financial elements, is also very important. Everybody loves swag, we know this, and also we saw this with the stickers that you have. But also, not being inclusive is not an option thing. It was not, like, I'm very happy that this is being discussed in many projects and many communities nowadays. It's not a good thing to have, it's a must. If you want to, your program, in our community, more than 60-70% of the participants or organizers of our yearly conference are girls. And I don't think we still are that much inclusive at all. There are other social groups that are not included in our communities at this point. But it's very important. Code of conduct, it's been discussed for many people, if we need to have it, if you don't need to have it, that's debatable. But I would say for a new community, it's better to have it than to avoid it. So since we, I think I reached my time. So I would say we need to find a way of different communities and also projects, just like we're doing right here now with different people doing different apps, get together. Just like I would like to see people share the ingredients of what works in one community and what doesn't work in one community, so that more and focus more on communities that do not exist yet. Just to jumpstart what they're doing. That's a huge potential to go in many cities and many countries. Of course, there are logistical issues there, but I think we can, with a little bit of coordination and knowledge sharing, we can do it. Thank you very much.